There are two devices which work on Lorentz force. The first one is velocity selector and second one is cyclotron. Let us describe first velocity selector and then we will go to the working of cyclotron. Let's talk about velocity selector. So velocity selector works on Lorentz force. We know that Lorentz force equation for electric field is Q times electric field. The force experienced by the charged particle in presence of electric field is F is equal to QE. Now, if you take the magnetic field, then F is equal to QV cross B. FB is equal to QV cross B. Let's consider that electric field is in this direction. That is, electric field is acting along y-axis. If the charged particle is projected with a velocity in x direction, and let's consider that magnetic field is along z direction. Here we can write E is equal to along electric field is the magnitude times it is along the y-axis. B the velocity so this is a vector notation. Now the force, this electric force is along J. Now the magnetic field is Q times V I cross B K. Now this will be Q V B I cross K. We know that if I cross J, then it becomes K. If reverse is there, J cross K is I and K cross I is J. But here it is I cross K. Therefore, it should be minus J. From the first and second equations, we can say that these two forces are acting one along J, positive J, the other along negative J. If we select in such a way the two fields that the force experienced by the charged particle in magnitude is same, then what we can write QE must be equal to QVB. Therefore, V is equal to E by B. So, this is the velocity expression, which is ratio of electric field magnitude by magnetic field magnitude. So you have to take the two fields in such a way. Suppose if you want to get some velocity as 5 meter per second, then this E must be 5 times then this B, so that if you divide it, you will get 5. So like that, we can make use of this formula to select the required velocities. That's why it is called velocity selector. This method was initially employed by J.J. Thomson to find the specific charge ratio E by M of an electron. He has taken the two fields perpendicular to each other. At the same time, he has selected the force should be the net force experienced by the charged particle is zero. That means the two forces must be acting with equal magnitudes and opposite in direction. So this is the work function of velocity selector. The application of velocity selector will be there in mass spectrometer, a device that separates charged particles. So, with the help of this, we can find out the velocities of the isotopes and velocities of the original charges.